thank you for joining me today. I'm really excited to share this video with you, my lock journey and also my holistic, healthy hair care regimen. It's minimalist and it is freeing and I love it. And so I want to share with any of you who might want a simpler hair care routine. So I have had locks, as you can well see. I started locks in 1994. It's pre-Lauryn Hill. And I was 1994 and 1995. I was a senior in high school. And the story was that I had been relaxing my hair since I can remember, since probably 10 or 11 or 12. All through high school, definitely. There was a brief moment of a jerry curl in middle school that we won't talk about. But all through high school, I was relaxing my hair. My mom was relaxing my hair, and she did a really great job of relaxing my hair, but I was very tender-headed. I routinely got scalp burns. And when I was 16 or 16 and a half, I wrote a poem called either No More Lies or The Lie. And I thought it was pretty clever. And it was interesting as we were using no lye relaxers, but lye, which is also known as sodium hydroxide, has a very high pH of 10 to 14. No lye relaxers also have a high pH, not quite as high, but still really elevated. And the problem, one of the many problems of relaxers, whether they're lye or no lye, is that they're basically caustic, extremely caustic, damaging to both the hair. That's actually how they work, by breaking down the disulfide bonds of your hair shaft. And they also are really caustic to your scalp, which is your skin. So I would be getting these scalp burns, and finally I was just like, I don't want to do this anymore. I told my mom, so she was about to put in another relaxer, and I said, not this time. I told her to cut it all off, cut off my relaxer, just keep my new growth. And she said, are you sure? And I will always thank my mother, because she only asked me one more time. She said, are you sure about this? Both times I said yes, and she cut off all my relaxed, chemically straightened hair. And all I was left with was my new growth, my kinky hair. And it was awesome. But I went with my new crop of new growth to school, and for the next 6 months I just kept a short crop of my natural kinky hair. And I just remember being in awe. I would look at myself in the mirror and play with it. And then after 6 months, it was definitely growing and growing and growing. And just intuitively, really intuitively, I just started playing with it and twisting it. I don't think it was two strand twists, or there was no, I don't know what the name of it was. I literally just created parts and started twisting, and my mother helped me do my entire head. And that's how I started my locks. And yeah, back in that time, there was no YouTube. So I was just literally intuitively thinking about how to take care of it. And it's been an incredible journey the past 22 plus years. Freeforming started for me about 6 years ago, and that was influenced by YouTube. And I was looking at other women's journeys and their stories about their lock journeys, and just really inspired, because I didn't grow up knowing other women who were locking at the time that I was. So to see this new crop of women come on the scene and share about their lock journeys, I loved seeing these beautiful women discovering their natural hair and rocking their locks. And it was one time I was watching one of these videos that I think I saw or heard about the idea of freeforming, and I was like, what is this? And so I did a little bit of research, and it just felt so right for me. So 6 years ago, I stopped retwisting my new growth. And initially I would separate the locks when they would start getting married into one another, but then I stopped doing that also. I found that after, by this point, 15 years of locking, my hair kind of knew where it needed to be, and so there wasn't a ton of marrying. And maybe that's also because of my hair texture. So I've had freeform locks for 6+ years now, and I'm going to share with you my regimen and why I love having locks. I am a minimalist. I love practicing a life of voluntary simplicity. I love having the time and the energy to do that, which I really love. And that's one reason why I've had locks for so long. My maintenance is next to none. I don't have to do very much. So here's what my maintenance looks like, and here's one of the many reasons I love having locks. I wash my hair, a water wash only. I use just water and really massage the water into my hair and into my scalp. And I do that twice to four times a week, just depending on the season, depending on where we are. We're now in Croatia, it's colder. I'm not going to the ocean every day, so I'm probably water washing my hair twice a week. There are times when we're in the tropics that I'm in the ocean and my hair is getting doused every single day. And my hair loves that. It drinks in that moisture. So that's what I do for washing. If it's super dirty, if I'm in a place that's really polluted, I might use Dr. Bronner's and dilute it heavily and use that as a shampoo. But to be honest, I haven't done that in a very long time, several months to almost a year. So water washing is what I do, and then I just air dry, and I don't put any oils in it. I don't put any conditioners, creams, nothing, because 20+ years of having locks have shown me that that just causes buildup for my hair. And one thing I want to say is that there's so many great inspiration. There's so many great inspirational stories on YouTube. But one thing that I found is that it's really important to find the regimen that works best for you, for your hair texture, for your personality, for your lifestyle. And what works best for me is no oils, no creams, no conditioners, no commercial shampoos whatsoever. I literally just water wash, air dry, and the only product I use is this, which is rose water. I love rose water. So I will spray this on my hair after coming out of the shower or after being in the sea, and my hair really gets well conditioned with that. If I don't have this, when we're traveling in the tropics, rose water in certain places is hard to find. I've used aloe vera, fresh aloe vera that I harvest from the plant, and I use just the gel, and I will use that in my hair naturally, and also that's a beautiful moisturizer for my hair. I also do hair massage, a scalp massage about twice a week. I just put my hands in my hair like this because your scalp is super vascular, which means it's got a lot of blood vessels just underneath the surface. If you cut your scalp, you will bleed like no man's business because there's so many vessels. But that's wonderful for getting circulation to your scalp and helping with hair growth. And so I love massaging my scalp twice a week. So that's part of my regimen. And I don't wrap my hair up. I just like my hair to be free. So I have a satin kimono, and in the evening I'll lay my satin kimono in the bed and I'll lay my hair on that. So that prevents it from drying too much. But I would say the most important thing in my hair regimen is my diet. I eat a vegan diet. I've been raw vegan for 6 years, and moving to a plant foods diet was one of the most important things that I did for my hair health. Because, and I need to be clear, it's a healthy plant foods diet. So tons of fruits, greens, which are so good for the hair because they're mineral rich. Drinking water and eating water rich foods, antioxidant rich foods, has been so great for my hair health. Now you might say, well, your hair isn't that long for 20+ years of having locks. I have a lot of shrinkage because of my hair texture and because I'm not twisting. So it kind of goes outish as opposed to down. And when I was twisting, my hair was way down in my back. I don't care for having really long hair. I cut my hair regularly, especially when I start, if I have any thinning at the end. But it's more important to me that it feels healthy and full. And so I love the way it looks. And I'll give you a 360 look at this point, just so you can see. So here's the hair. I do have what are called two-headed dragons, but not a ton of them. So that's when the hair marries together. But for the most part, they kind of do what they want to do and I let them. And that brings me to the second reason I love freeform locks, which is just the freedom of it. I love also the fact that I feel like it helps to nurture my self-love and self-confidence because I'm rocking the hair that God gave me. So I get to nurture my God-given beauty. And that feels really good, and it's felt really good for 20 plus years. A little story, a little aside, is that I'm originally from Nigeria, and my father, when I started showing my locks, was really leery of it and wasn't up for it at all. He at first thought it was a phase, but it's been a very long phase. And I think a lot of parents might be worried about your ability to get a job, to progress in your career, because there has been stigma in the past, and some places continues to be stigma around the locks. I'm a medical doctor. I started growing my locks in high school. So for my college interviews, for my medical school interviews, for my residency, my medical residency interviews, which is what happens after you finish medical school and then you're going to be a hospital doctor, I had locks. During my surgical rotations, my locks were down my back. And I would use, before going to the OR, I would use two OR operating room caps to keep my hair in place. I share all that to say that locks don't have to get in your way of being a career person if that is what you're looking for, if that's what resonates with you. That I've been able to have locks for 22 years and progress beautifully in my careers. And I do know that there are some real discriminations around hair, but what I can share with you is that it doesn't always have to be that way. And you emanating self-confidence and self-love, I think, goes much longer and much further than you can imagine. So I wanted to share that with you. Another reason I love having freeform locks and locks in general is that I don't need to go to a salon to have my hairstyle. I've never gone to a salon in the 20 plus years that I've had locks. I don't need to. I do all my hair care by myself, and that's so freeing. And I also spend pennies on my hair per month. Literally, I showed you the only product I use for my hair. And that also is freeing. That's also minimalism and frees up my expenditures to spend my money and my time and my energy on other things that are more exciting for me. Gone are the days of lots of time spent taking care of my hairstyle. I literally, my hair care looks like in the morning I wake up and I go. I don't do anything. And that also is really freeing. And last but not least, certainly not least, especially given what my channel is about, what I really focus on this channel, I feel like my locks and having natural hair just supports my best health. I'm a dancer and I dance every day. I love swimming, I love running, I love moving my body, and that usually comes along with sweating. And I don't want to have to worry about, oh my God, I can't go to the water because of my hair. Oh my God, I can't sweat too much because of my hair. I don't have this issue, and so I'm able to be physically as fit as I want to be. That's supported by my hair and the hairstyle I choose to wear. Also, health-wise, I am not putting any crazy products and chemicals into my hair or on my scalp anymore. I mentioned before, our scalp is our skin, and it's one of the most vascular, most well-supplied areas in terms of blood vessels of our skin. Which means that what you put on your scalp will get absorbed, especially if you're putting that product on regularly. That includes chemical relaxers, that includes shampoos, conditioners, hair oils, scalp oils. So my biggest take home, my biggest thing I want to share with you is please, whatever hairstyle you're rocking, please read the ingredients of whatever thing you're planning to put in your hair and on your scalp. Hair products are not regulated by the FDA in America. And therefore, it's so vital to read what the ingredients are. and to understand that those ingredients are going to find their way into your system. So for me personally, if it's not something that I would ingest, I'm not going to put it into my hair or my scalp. And sodium hydroxide, which is lye, as well as no lye relaxers, because of their high pH, because of the chemical ingredients, have been linked to uterine fibroids. If you are a woman who suffers from uterine leiomyomas or fibroids, please reconsider if you're using any of these chemicals on your hair. I have a webinar on holistic treatment without the use of pharmaceuticals or surgery for uterine fibroids, and I'll put a link to that webinar down below. Please check that out. Please share with other women. Relaxers have also been linked to early on-stage puberty for women. So it really messes up our hormonal balance, as well as creating scalp lesions and scalp burns in which you can then get infected. And relaxers have also been linked to higher levels of staphylococcal infections because of this. So please read the ingredients in anything you're gonna put on your scalp and in your hair. And that's my biggest take-home point with making this video. But I also just want to encourage any of you who are resonating and thinking of starting LOX to go for it. When I started LOX 20 plus years ago, I didn't think this is going to be a 20 plus year journey or for the rest of my life. I just thought this is what feels good right now. And it has continued to feel good for 22 years. You're never locked in. You can take out your LOX, you can cut them off. But I have felt the opposite of being restricted by my locks. I have felt freed up. So I hope that this is inspiring to you, empowering to you. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. Please share with anybody who you think might benefit from it. And subscribe to my videos for more weekly videos on health and minimalism. And until the next time, much love to you.